Today, Professor Dr. Manoj Kumar will speak on the grading of the Industrial Training Institute. This letter is issued by the Industrial Training Department of the Kerala State from the Additional State Director Protector to the all principal of the all government ITI. That he received the skill strengthening of the industrial value enhancement for the development of the industrial sector in India. For the smooth functioning of the scheme, the DGT informed that all government ITI in the state are requested to self-rating their ITI in the NCBT MIS portal. It is most important work and should be completed before the date 17-12-2006. The principals are requested to forward a completion report to the inspector of the training on their region on or before 17-12-2006 for self-rating. The inspector of training are directed to submit a combined report to the SPU for the completion of self-rating and also directed to submit an interim report and abbreviation. The detailed instruction of the self-rating are attached here. This is the 2016 grading of the Industrial Training Institute framework and the methodology. The contents here are the background, need for grading of the ITIs, grading framework, grading methodology, timeliness, benefits of the grading, grading parameter and their significance, and the answer in given where the grading parameters and scoring is provided. Background: skilling has been one of the most focused agenda of the government of India for the last few years. India is targeting to equip 4,000 million youth by the 2022 with industry relevant skills and training in the multiple trade sector through various skills program schemes implemented at skilling institution such as a school skill development center, vocational training provider, industrial training institute and polytechnics and engineering colleges. Initiative like Make in India, Digital India, start the creating job opportunity in the key manufacturing and the service sector of the economy. There were demanding quality skills manpower. However, a significant gap exists between the demand for the skilled manpower and the supply of such manpower through a skilling institution such as ITI. Apart from this, 12 million people enter the workforce every year who not only need to have jobs, but who also need to have required skills for the different job roles. While this is a large number in itself, added to this is the complexity that about 93% of the workers are in the informal sector, which is transient in the nature. Need for the government of the ITI. The government's vocational training programs are primarily managed by the ITI, which cater to about 36% of the 7 million people getting trained in India today. The first ITI was set up in the 1950 and the number today stands up 12,392, including both government and the private ITI. Providing vocational training to more than 25 lakh youths in more than 126 trades. With such a speed increase in the number of ITI, it is necessary to have a standard quality assurance mechanism in place to ensure the quality checks of these institutes. Directorate General of the Training, Ministry of the Skill Development and Entrepreneurship had decided to grade the ITI on the basis of the some key parameter. The grading shall provide a benchmark for comparison amongst the institute. The National Policy on the Skill Development and Entrepreneurship 2050 also emphasizes on the grading of the ITI. It states performance rating of the ITI will also be promoted based on the outcome linked parameter and trainee employer feedback. The objective of conducting grading exercise for ITI is to provide star rating to the performing institute and give an opportunity to the institute lagging behind in some of the parameter. To improve upon, the scoring shall be done against each of the defined parameter. Composite scores of the institute shall determine its current performance level and shall enable them to find out the key areas where they can improve further so as to get higher rating during the next grading process. Grading framework. A comprehensive framework has been designed to detail out the key parameters on which the performance of the each institute shall be evaluated and graded accordingly. The primary purpose of this framework is to galvanize ITI, providing a competitive environment so as to improve their current operational performance. Clear definition and identification of the key parameter shall help ITIs to work concurrently towards maintaining the highest level of performance standards and further improving their rating. These parameters are strong pointers of the quality of training being imparted at ITI across the country. The parameters, total 39, are grouped under 10 heads such as the civil work, trades, industry connect, outcome, instructors, production center, capacity utilization, compliance with the DGT instruction, special achievement, and miscellaneous. Essentially, the grading parameters would evaluate the civil work of the institute in terms of the building completion, rented or own building, etc., status of the institute management committee, and the level of the institute industry engagement, availability, and specific of the machines, tools, and equipment as per DGT norms. Availability of the high-end machines, ability of the qualified instructor as per DGT norms. Instructor vacancy, ability of the full-time principal, ability of the books, dropout rate, placement, pass-out ratio, capacity utilization, ability of the high-end trade, industry involvement in delivering guest lectures, diversity in revenue streams, among other things are there. The grading process shall be voluntary in nature, and only those ITI desirous of the obtaining rating under this framework shall be required to submit information data for the purpose. The detailed grading parameters along with the information data to be provided, weights assigned and scoring against each parameter has been provided in the Annexure 1. The DGT MSD has reserved the right to modify any of the matrices of it deems fit to do so in the interest of the various stakeholders. Any change so made, it will be notified at the time of the announcing the rating. Grading methodology. The methodology is based on the developing a set of matrices for the rating of the ITI based on the parameter agreed upon the DGT MST. An attempt is also made to identify the relevant data needed to suitably measure the performance score under such parameter. Here the emphasis is on the identifying the data that an ITI can easily provide and can easily verifiable, where verification is needed. This is important in the interest of the transparency. A suitable metric is then proposed based on this data, which computes a score under each parameter. The parameters have appropriate weight assigned to them. The parameter scores are then added to obtain scores for each individual head. The methodology of grading of the ITI shall include the following state. DGT MSD shall invite interested ITI to participate in the grading exercise. Interested ITI shall rate themselves on the grading parameters defined in the Annexure 1. This shall be enabled using assigned user ID and password through a web link in NCBT MIS portal. On the rating web page, ITI will be able to mention actual value of the data information against each parameter. It is also desirable that ITI also upload the submitted data on their own publicly visible website in the interest of the transparency. State to various users such as a trainee, parent, faculty, employer, and visitor, anonymous having no meeting, shall rate on the ITI some grading parameter defined in Annexure 1 through a co-art source link available in MS NCBT MIS portal. The self-rating of ITI will be visible to users of the crowdsourcing platform. The objective of this step is to get a calibrated view through the eliciting feedback from the key stakeholder. A core grading committee shall be constituted. We shall evaluate and provide provisional star rating to an ITI giving proposed 70% weightage to ITI self-rating and 30% weightage to rating from the crowdsourcing. The rating criteria has been defined in the table below. Rating criteria will be based on the final score span, score range 40 to 50, 5 star, 30 to 40, 4 star, 20 to 30, 3 star, 10 to 20, 2 star, 0 to 10, 1 star. The maximum score which an ITI can score is 50 after duly applying appropriate weights to each parameter as mentioned in the Annexure 1. Step 4, the DGT or states or the both shall assign NPU and SPU officials respectively to the visit the concerned ITI, validate the submitted data and provide rating against some grading parameters through their respective login facility in the NCBT MIS portal. The self-rating given by an ITI and by the various users along with the comments remark shall be visible to assigned NPU, SPU official while giving rating. Further, NPU, SPU should be able to provide overall comments, remarks while giving rating to an ITI. An inspecting officer to be assigned by the DGT shall visit the allotted ITI to validate the submitted data and provide its own rating against some grading parameter to an ITI through a wavelink of the NCBT MIS portal. The states may also assign their one inspecting officer to carry out this process. The self-rating given by the ITI by various user through the crowdsourcing by the NPU, SPU along with the comments, remarks shall be visible to assigned inspecting officer while giving rating. Further, inspecting officer should be able to provide overall comments, remarks while giving rating to an ITI. The record of the comments, remarks shall form the base for future inspection or monitoring of ITI against the exceeding grade parameters of the change parameter after appropriate revision in the future. Also, MSD DGT will be able to carry out an independent audit of entire grading process, inspection record, and comments remark to establish the veracity of the claim, statement made, and data information collected in relation to the grading. A suitable financing mechanism shall be worked out for the purpose of the payment to the inspecting officers. However, part financing shall be done by Government of India. The core grading committee shall provide final rating of the each ITI based on the evaluation report submitted by the inspection officer. The final rating will be based on the same criteria as defined above in the step 3. It is found that an ITI has deliberately manipulated in the submitted data, causing enormous ranking. DGT will improve the ITI from rating list and publish a suitable note to this effect. If an ITI loses its affiliation status at any point of time and loses its rating. Timeliness, the grading process is expected to be completed in about 3 months and rating published on this one. The grading exercise will be conducted after every 1 year, which will provide an opportunity for low graded institute to perform better and score higher during the next grading process. Benefits of the grading. Grading of ITI will be held differentiate between the performing and the non-performing ITI instead of continuing with a standardized approach of supporting, non-supporting them. It would also contribute to the skill ecosystem in number of ways, such as a comprehension and identification of ITI incorporating the best practices, enabling healthy competition among the ITI, providing relevant information to potential trainee, becoming preferred choice, imply corporates enabling an ITI to benchmark itself with other ITI across the country and in the same state or region, etc. Following benefits will be accrued to ITI scoring rating of the 4 and above. Flexibility in charging higher course fee from the student. Suitable financial incentives in the form of the subsidy, soft loan. Automatic affiliation at the end of the validity of the current affiliation. Other government-funded skill development scheme, corporate social responsibility projects, grading parameters and their significance. There are 39 grading parameter categorized into the 10 heads, which are defined as under the documentary proof to be checked, verified at the time of visit by the inspecting officer shall be made by the available by the ITI management. Civil works dedicated road fight for ITI with the boundary wall ends credibility to continuity of the ITI operation and provide flexibility to the IT management to expand its operation in terms of the starting more trades courses and setting up facility for other training related activity. It also encourages target segment trainee parents to inquire about the institute and its program and make the institute aspirational. An ITI with a dedicated plot will be given highest rating. Documentary proof, title deed of the plot of the land. Availability of the building completion certificate by the competent authority is necessary to ensure that the relevant building codes and standard of the competent authority have been compiled with. ITI with the certificate will score highest rate under this. If an ITI has a certificate of approval of the building plan by the competent authority, it shall also get some score as prescribed. Building completion certificate, approved building plan. On building of ITI also lends credibility of continuity of the IT operation compared to the rented building. It also provides flexibility of the IT management to expand its operation in terms of the starting more units and providing extra facility, which had direct bearing on the training outcome. ITI with the own building will score highest under this. Lease agreement in case of the own building on the lease land and the last paid property tax receipt. Title deed of the land in case of the own building on one land and the last paid property tax receipt. Trades, diversity of the trades, available of the trades over and fitter and electrician is important to increase ITI to provide training in order to prevent as per the needs of the economy. In this way, ITI can contribute significantly to the manpower requirement to the key sectors of the economy, such as electronics, manufacturing, which are in line with the national program of the Government of India. Hence, the more number of additional trades, higher as the score. NCBT application order for the additional trade. Ability of the high-end advanced trade, such as a machinist, turner, welder, MMB, MMD, RAC, tool and die making, digital photography, power electronics signifies that the training period at ITI in the industry relevant to the contributing to the manpower requirement as per the changing needs of the economy. It also shows ITI progressive in carrying out skill development activity. Hence, more the number of the advanced trade, higher is the score. This trade must meet the reaffiliation norm. NCBT application, reaffiliation order for the high-end advanced trade. Ability of the high-end machinery and equipment categorized as optional as per the NCBT norms, signifying the progressive of the ITI and its endeavor to modernize its training staff infrastructure in line with the skill set required by the industry. ITI with the more high-end machinery and equipment will score more. The list of the optional machinery and equipment is attached for the reference. Physical inspection and photographs of the high-end machinery and the equipment. Reaffiliation of the all trade as per the latest NCBT norm is necessary to ensure the ITI have the duly followed the reaffiliation procedure and the machinery and equipment has been updated for the relevant trade. ITI with the completed reaffiliation for the updated trades will score highest. Reaffiliation order, physical inspection and photograph of the updated machinery and the equipment. Industry Connect, number of the MOU signed with the industry, at least SME for the industrial visit of the student. Number of the industrial visit of trainee are necessary to ensure that the trainee are up to date in the industry requirement and latest technology and also familiar with the industry setting and the work environment. A first hand exposure to industry will be significantly boost the confidence level of the trainee. This parameter shall assess the efforts undertaken by the ITI in getting MOU signed with the industry in this regard. Under this, more number of the active MOU will make an ITI eligible for the higher score. Physical copy of the MOU. Number of trainee who have sent for the dual training also assesses the efforts undertaken by the ITI in operationalizing the dual system of the training. More the number of students under the system, higher is the score. physical copy of MOU signed with the industry for the Dole 20. Functional IMC in case of the government of ITI and similar institutional mechanism in case of the private ITI. To ensure that the ITI has a proper institutional mechanism, effectively govern the institute. Functional IMC means the meeting of the IFC have been held on a regular basis as per the agenda defined at the beginning of the year or the session. A similar institution mechanism for a private could be a society board trust which has adequate representation from the industry, or industry has significant role in playing the training operation through an appropriate forum. Further, the IMC or a similar institution mechanism is instrumental in facilitating industry institute engagement. ITI with such mechanism will score highest. Minutes of meeting of the latest IMC meeting in case of the government ITI and certificate of the incorporation of the institutional mechanism in case of the private ITI. Number of guest faculty from industry is important to ensure that trainees are up to date in the industry requirement and latest industrial technology. Further, the presence of the guest faculty will enhance the confidence of the trainee and create competitive environment amongst the ITI instructor. Hence, more the involvement of the guest faculty, higher is the score. Attendance record of the guest faculty.